Hi everyone, Mehmet is here. Today I will talk about coloring on Desmos. Let's get started. This is the third video of Desmos Art video series. If you missed first two videos, the links are in the description below. Today we are going to color three graphs. First two graphs are from the first video, and the third graph, I just did it for you guys. And again, all the links and everything in the description below. Okay, let's open the graphs and start working on them. This is Desmos Art playlist on my YouTube channel. I will go to video 1 and open two graphs that we created together. We are going to color those graphs first. By the way, don't forget to log in Desmos to save the graphs. You can click the graph title, then create the name if you want. I already have the mathematics graph, that's why I am going to change it. Oh, I also have copy and copy 2, so I will name this as copy 3. And the second one, let's name this one as well. And you see all the saved graphs here are on my profile. Okay, before we start working on those graphs, I will give you the general idea behind coloring on Desmos. Coloring is all about inequalities, because when inequalities are graphed on a coordinate plane, the solutions are located in a region, which is represented as a shaded area on the plane. So we are going to use those areas in our graphs and color them. For example, y equals 2x represents a line, right? But if I change it to y is bigger than 2x, it shades the left side of the graph. So let's change the sign. The right side is shaded now. Okay, so that's basically the main idea behind coloring on Desmos. Strict inequalities like bigger than or smaller than creates dotted lines. But if you want to create a solid line, you need to use non-strict inequalities like bigger than or equal to and smaller than or equal to. You can also change the style by clicking the settings icon here. It offers you only 6 colors and you can choose from those. There's another way to choose more colors and we will talk about that later. You can also disable this option to remove the line. You see, it is not visible now. We only have the areas. You may need this one for your project. Let's talk about the area between the lines. Of course, we can use two or more equations and create areas by using those. For example, here are my two equations. I am going to use both as a compound inequality, and you see it shades the right part. You can also shade other parts by changing the inequality sign. We can also do the same with curves. Here are two curves. We can choose the area between the curves, just like that. We can also change the design, right? Okay, sometimes the inequality for the shaded area looks complicated. They always ask me like how I get those equations, right? I basically copy and paste them. But you don't have to do that. Sometimes it's time consuming to write. Sometimes it's time consuming to copy and paste. There's an easier way. You can name equations. Give them special names and then write inequalities easily. For example, let's name the first one as equation 1. I'm just gonna call them E1. You need to write a capital letter and then just write the number value. It automatically becomes a subvalue here. Let's also name the second one as E2. Okay, so now you can just write the inequality by using E1 and E2. You see? It looks simpler, better now. Let's talk about coloring in circles. It works the same. You can color it with inequalities. Okay, I think you understand the logic behind coloring, shading on Desmos. Now, let's start coloring our graphs. I will start with mathematics logo. The first thing I will do is naming equations because I believe it looks better if we do that. I will name them just like that. First one is E1, second one is E2, etc. And then I will create a folder. Name it as coloring and I will keep all the inequalities here. Okay, let's start. Now, choose the area you want to color and then click the borders. Click the lines you want to use. For example, this is equation 2 and this is E38. Now I will use those two to write the inequality, so I don't need to copy and paste equations. That's why naming is super useful. Just think about how y values look like and write the inequality. You can also try and see how different inequalities look like and then you will find the right one. The other side is between E38 and E1. They have different colors, but we will talk about that at the end. I will continue with this line, E39, and this is E3. You can do all the parts just like that. Okay, let me turn on the projector mode. You will see it better like that. The left border of the logo has constant x values, so we can write an inequality with x. If you do that, this area will be shaded. But there's a problem here, and you will realize it after I complete the next part. Let's shade this one. So here there is an unshaded area left between those areas. So we either need to use x in both inequalities or y to solve the problem. I will use y and change the left side just like that. And I will add a restriction here. You can add restrictions to areas as well. Look at this, guys. The red area is created. It is shading all the parts we need. So I will delete the old one. Great. Let's continue coloring. I will do the same for the right side. Wonderful. Okay, we finished shading. Let's work on the design. I will color all areas the same, blue color. Now I will remove all the lines in the areas and do a few more things. Let's change the settings and make axes, grid and numbers invisible. It looks good. One more thing, there are only 6 colors on Desmos, but you can add any colors you want. To do that, open the console on your internet browser. If you are using Google Chrome, F12 or function plus F12 opens it. Then paste this code. The code is in the description below, guys. So just copy it from there and paste it to the console here. It adds custom colors to Desmos, and then you need to find the color code. For example, I want to choose a kind of blue color. I will search for blue color hex codes. And you see, guys, there are a lot of colors, and just choose one of them. Yep, here is the color code. Copy it and paste it here in quotation marks. Then press enter. That's it. The color will show up on the design settings. Let's check this out. Yes, we can use it now. It looks much better. I also want to make line colors all black. Let's change the line colors. Yep, it's good. Order of expressions is important on Desmos. If the expression is further down, it appears better. So basically the expression at the bottom is covering up the expressions at the top. So if you want your lines to appear full black, move the line equations down and move the coloring up. Place the coloring at the top. And now the lines around blue areas are covering up all those areas and appearing darker. Maybe you don't see it clearly for this one because what I'm saying is not appearing really well, but I will do the same thing for the last graph, for the Game Boy graph, and you will see that it changed the graph a lot. It's an important step. Anyways, that's it for the first graph. Let's continue coloring. The second one will be easy. Let's color this yin yang symbol. Now we are going to apply the same strategy to circles. We can also name circles, but I will not do that for now. I will talk about that in another video because it's a little bit different. Okay, let's start with this semicircle. I will color inside, so I copied and pasted the equation and put the inequality sign here. Circle is smaller than the radius, so the inner part will be colored. But I want small circle to stay white, so I will add a restriction here. I will copy the small circle equation and paste it here in curly brackets. Then I will choose the outside of the circle, so the equation will be bigger than the radius. Okay, that's great. Let's also color the other part, the left part. I chose the other semicircle and colored the outside of it. Great. We need to set another restriction here and limit it to inside the big circle. I will choose the big circle equation, copy the equation, and then paste it here. I will choose the inner area. Okay, but there is one more thing. I also need to exclude the small circle one more time at the top. Let's choose it. I will copy it from the previous restriction because it's the same, right? And paste it here. Done. Finally, let's create the area for the small circle. Great! Now we are ready to color it. Let's make the shadings black. That's great. Let's hide grids and axes. And we colored the second graph. The last one, Game Boy graph. I already named the equations. Let's start coloring. I'm going to start with the curve in the right bottom corner. I will color until here and it is y equals 20. So it needs to be less than that. Great. I also need to exclude the circles, of course. Let's write restrictions by choosing outside of the circles, just like that. Okay, this part is ready. Let's continue graphing rectangles. Let's quickly finish these parts. Okay, now it's time to work on the left bottom part, the part with navigation buttons. We cannot exclude them as we do with circles because the buttons do not have one equation. It consists of 12 equations. If you could write it as one equation, and there's a way to write it, you can exclude it easily. But if you are a beginner and you could just write it like that, you need to create regions and color them part by part. For example, you can create 8 small rectangles and work on coloring each part. Again, this is not what Desmos Pros are doing, but it is a good thing to start. I will record a video about Desmos Pro tips later. Okay, done. Let's remove all the lines in shading and color it to orange. Let's see how it looks. Okay, it's great. Let's continue. I'm going to put a black border around the screen. Great. And also I will color buttons. I will make the circles red. And I will make the screen kind of blue. And let's color the navigation button. If you color it in two parts, you see the middle one is colored twice and it looks darker. To avoid having darker areas, you need to color them separately, part by part. Okay, I was talking about making black lines more visible, right? You can see it clearly now. Look at this. When I move the coloring folder at the top, the line and circle equation now become more visible, become darker, and the Game Boy looks better now. So order of expressions matters on Desmos. It's really important and it makes your project look better. Look at the difference here. Coloring at the top, lines are more visible. Coloring at the bottom, lines are less visible. Okay, it's good, but I don't like the colors. Desmos do not offer a lot of colors here, and I will use the same code in the description below. Just paste it in console and add custom colors. I will make the Game Boy yellow. Let's add this. I will make the screen light blue. Let me try this one. Good. And let's change the circle colors and make it a different shade of red. Yeah, I like it. And I will make the navigation buttons black. Awesome. Okay, the last project is also done. All the links are in the description below. Open the links, save them on your Desmos, and work on them. Try, practice coloring. Believe me, it is fun. Okay guys, that's it for today. I will continue to record videos about Desmos art. If you have any questions, just comment below and let me know. I'll be with you in another video about online teaching. Keep watching Mathematics. Goodbye.